Okay, so in this video I'm going to show how I do the skull engraving on the chef knife, on the 210mm Damascus chef knife. And it's kind of hard to see because it depends on the reflection, the angle you look at. But you can see it here, it changes. So like I said, this is a 210mm blade, and this is a Damascus, so it's gonna affect the settings in the laser software. And so here in the laser software, we're gonna check the settings. I'm gonna show you all those. So properties, LP type, and the LP type is set to Carver blade logo. I have to go to options, laser parameter settings, global LP table, and look in Carver blade logo here. So I'll show you all the different settings for that. These are the power, frequency, speed, line width, pulse width settings. Galvo usually stays the same. Delay beam, raster and wobble, they usually don't do anything. So cancel, just wanted to show the settings for that. So here it says align spine along laser line. So in the laser, I have this red laser line that I've aligned along the top edge, and then the crosshair, the vertical crosshair, comes down this way. So that's gonna, you can see where the skull is engraved is the same, the cross, relative to the crosshairs, is the same location as where this blue line is. So the blue line represents the crosshairs. So that's the left side of the blade, and that's specifically says Laughing Skull left, Shannon Cook, who is the designer of the skull, the artist, centered for 210mm Damascus Gyoto, 30mm height. So now we're going to go to the right side, and the right side you're going to notice is flipped upside down. So again, you align the blue line along the spine of the laser. So we're going to flip this around, set it like this. Align the laser line along the spine. Place this block kind of as far out as you can so it doesn't affect it, sets the right angle. The block is to keep the blade from tilting down, so the blade surface is mostly horizontal. So there we go. Now we're ready to start the engraving. Just have to click start here. Start marking. And this is going to take a while because it's a pretty slow lasering to get the black mark on the stainless. Here the engraving is about 2/3 of the way complete. This is real-time speed. The one setting that I didn't talk about so far is the height of the laser beam. So the laser is set at about 3mm above the focal point, the normal focal point. And what that does is it makes a little bit wider beam, and it doesn't etch as deep into the metal. It doesn't like vaporize the metal. Instead, it does more of a color change to the metal, but like a deep penetrative color change. So it doesn't just, it's not going to rub off the surface, or you can't even scratch it off or sand it off. It's pretty deep in there. Well, if you sand hard enough, anything's going to be removable. So once the laser is finished doing its thing and the window in the software pops up to show that it's successfully finished, you can open this door and check it out. What I find really interesting is the way that it kind of appears and disappears. It's almost like the ghost skull. Really depends on the way the light shines and how you're looking at it. It's a really cool effect. So that's on both sides of this now. Oh, we still need to do the logo on the blade here.